it's not every day that I get to rescue a damsel in distress. Let me help you. It's just this way.
Check the Heisenberg compensators. I'll run a level one diagnostic of the pattern buffers. See if there's any kind of field imbalance.
Chief.
Any news from Starfleet?
Nothing good. As far as I can tell, Commander Sisko and the others never materialized in San Francisco. According to their sensors, our transporter signal disintegrated immediately after we began the beam-out sequence.
That doesn't agree with our records. The system log shows that the transport was successfully completed. They definitely materialized somewhere.
Well, that's good news anyway. But the question is where?
I wish I knew. Whatever the answer is, it's not in the log. The only unusual thing it recorded was the variance in the annular confinement beam.
But you corrected for that.
It was a simple adjustment. The beam was just reacting to the accumulation of chroniton particles in the ship's hull.
Chroniton particles?
They're emitted by the cloaking device. They sometimes become lodged in the ship's ablative armor matrix.
But we've used the transporter many times since the cloaking device was installed. There's never been a problem before.
I don't know why there should be one now. Wait a minute. It looks like there was a surge in temporal energy seconds before the initiation of the transporter sequence.
Tell me that's a clue.
Well, it's a clue, all right. I just don't know what it means yet.
How do you feel?
Better.
Me too. Probably transporter shock. Disorienting, but it wears off quickly. I know one thing. We're definitely in San Francisco. I caught a glimpse of the Golden Gate Bridge a few blocks back.
I saw it too.
You know what happened to our comm badges?
They were probably stolen while we were unconscious. This is not the Earth we're used to, Doctor. That's still at least a century away. I wonder what happened to Dax.
Now, she was caught in the transporter beam with us. Whatever affected us must have affected her too.
That means she's probably somewhere nearby. The first chance we get, we've got to find her.
And then what?
And then we find our way home.
All right, let's go. Bring them.
Okay, let's go. Hurry it up.
Someone is gonna kill me.
What is this place?
Sanctuary District.
21st century history is not one of my strong points. Too depressing.
It's been a hobby of mine. They made some ugly mistakes. But they also paved the way for a lot of things we now take for granted.
I assume this is one of those mistakes.
A bad one. By the early 2020s, there was a place like this in every major city in the United States.
Why are these people in here? Are they criminals?
No, people with criminal records weren't allowed in the sanctuary districts.
Then what do they do to deserve this?
Nothing. Just people. Without jobs or places to live.
So they get put in here?
Welcome to the 21st century, Doctor.
Oh, they're right there. If you want to go home, go home. What do I care?
Thanks, man.
Shall we?
Hi. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Were you able to order a new ID?
Just finished. It took me a while to convince them. I was who I said I was. They'll be expressing a transit pass and a couple of credit chips in a few hours. I asked them to send it here. I hope you don't mind.
No problem.
Thanks for letting me use your terminal and your account.
You know, those are very unusual.
Oh, you mean my tattoos?
This is amazing work. Where did you have them done? Japan?
How did you guess?
Well, I used to have one myself. A Maori tribal pattern used to go all the way down my arm. Got it in high school back in the 90s, just like everybody else. Of course, I had to have it removed. Well, you know how it is. To get the government contracts, you have to look like all the rest of the drones. So I guess that makes me a sellout.
Not necessarily.